welcome back to my YouTube channel. It's Sheree here, subscribe if you're new. In today's video, I'm going to be doing a Netflix recommendations video of Netflix shows and movies that I recommend you guys to watch because they're so good. And I hope you like this video. Please give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And shout out to all my fans of Christchurch. And hope you liked this video. If you did enjoy it and you want me to do more TV recommendations, movie recommendations, or you want to know about my favorite movies or favorite TV shows, a part two to my favorite TV shows, because I only did my top three favorite TV shows in my last video. So let me know in the comment section down below any video ideas, just in case I get stuck on video ideas. But yeah, let's just get started with the video. So the first TV show that I recommend you guys to watch on Netflix is one of my favorite TV shows of all time, Riverdale. If you're into mystery and if you're like me and you're really into mystery and finding out like murder stuff, like for example, it makes you really think of who did this, who was really behind this murder on Riverdale. And if you're really into mystery and you find out who done it and who did this and all that kind of stuff, and you're really into like mystery and kind of like good like scary horror kind of things, like if you're into those kind of TV shows, then I recommend you watch Riverdale because it's so good. And has KJ Apa from Salt and Straight. If you watch Salt and Straight, he played Kane on Salt and Straight, and now he's in LA doing Riverdale, and I'm so excited that it's gonna be ready for season 3, and it comes out in October, which is a very long time. I don't know why that long, but anyway, if you're into mystery and who did this, who done it, it makes you think more. If you're into those kind of shows, I recommend you watch Riverdale because it's a goodie. And I would binge watch all the episodes because I love it so much, and it's so, so, so good if you're into like mystery and drama and kind of that behind that sort of stuff. So the second show I'm going to be recommending you guys to watch on Netflix is Stranger Things. If you're, as I said, for Riverdale, if you're into mystery, horror, and all that scary kind of scenes, that's really, really hard to watch. If you're into that kind of stuff, like mystery, if you're into those kind of stuff and makes you think really a lot about the clues and all of that kind of stuff, then I recommend you watch Stranger Things. I have watched the whole of season 1, but I haven't seen the whole. I'm still on episode 2 or 3 for season 2, so I have to catch up on that on Netflix. But I recommend you guys to watch it if you're really into like mystery and if you like horror kind of movies and TV shows. You just like, it's quite interesting, it's really interesting. I was like, when I first watched a few episodes, I was like, okay, I don't think I'm gonna enjoy this. But then it gets really interesting and makes you, it's a lot of drama and it's really, really, really good. So if you haven't seen Stranger Things, it's a really good show. And I just recommend you guys to watch it before season 3 comes out, so make sure you guys watch it. And it's so, so good. It's like intense, insane, but good at the same time, if you know what I mean. So if you like that sort of stuff, mystery, horror, that kind of stuff, then make sure you guys watch Stranger Things because it is insanely good. I recommend you to binge watch it. Okay guys, so the third and final TV show I'm going to be talking about is Pretty Little Liars. If you're like into mystery and kind of like, some of it is kind of scary, but if you like into the previous two TV shows to talk about Stranger Things and Riverdale, then you'll be into this. But I find this series quite frustrating because it's so confusing. Basically season 1 is this person called A, and this A person keeps on threatening them with text messages of the four girls, Aria, Hannah, Spence, and Emily, all four of those girls, and he, the person who's A is threatening them to do things for the person who's A, and it's so confusing because season one, two is who was A, like who is A, and then next is who is AD, and next is who is AAAD, and which is so confusing, like come on, pick. Just pick who is A, and that's the end of it. You don't have to do AD and AD. I know it gets really interesting when it's from who's going to be A, who's going to be AD, and all that kind of stuff. But I think it's really, really annoying and frustrating. But I still watch it. I'm still on season three. It's really good, but I just, it's frustrating sometimes. But it's a really good show. If it's like scary kind of stuff, then that would be your show. So I recommend you guys to watch it. It's really, really good, but it's some of the stuff is scary, so you better be cautious and careful before you watch it. So just prepare you guys, but it's really, really, really good. Okay, so the first movie I'm gonna be talking about and recommending you guys watch on Netflix is definitely The Hunger Games. If you're into sci-fi fantasy and mystery, as I said before, I really love The Hunger Games because it makes you really think, and it's a really good sci-fi fantasy movie if you're into science fiction. And I just love it so much. It's quite cool because it's about this girl called Katniss Everdeen, and she volunteers as tribute because she doesn't want her sister to go into the games, so she volunteered as tribute. Basically, her and this other guy called Peter have to survive in the Hunger Games, which is basically they have to do everything they can to survive in the game and try to make it out alive and survive and do all these different things. I think it's really interesting if you're into science fiction, and I love the movie so much. And I recommend you guys to watch it if you're into science fiction, like Divergent series, the Hunger Games movies. If you're into that, like science fiction, if you've read the books, read Hunger Games books, they're really, really good. But I recommend you guys to watch it because it's really good, and it doesn't make you think, but it just challenges you and it's just quite interesting to watch for me, but it depends if you're into science fiction or not. If you're not, then this movie is not really for you to watch. But I quite recommend you guys to watch it. I think it's really good. I watched it like 10 more times, and I love the movie so much. They're so good and incredible, and I just love science fiction movies. They're so good. Okay, so the last and second movie I'm going to be recommending you guys to watch Netflix is The Kissing Booth, which is about two best friends they were born the same day and the same year, born since birth, been best friends since birth, and basically they've been best friends, right? And she likes his brother, but she can't date his brother because apparently they made these rules since they were six. And dating your best friend's sibling is definitely off limits, so she can't really date him. But she does date him anyway, and along the way, he gets angry about it first, but then he gets over it, and he wants his best friend to be happy, so he just gets over it. And I think it's a really good movie. It's a really cool movie, and I think you should definitely watch it. I've been watching it for the second time again, and I'm gonna be watching. All right, guys, that's the end of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed this Netflix recommendations of TV shows and movies that I recommend you guys to watch on Netflix because they're really good, and I recommend you guys to watch it. So I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you did enjoy it, please leave a like and comment and subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll see you guys tomorrow for a new video. And don't forget, on Friday I'm doing a Followers Control My Life on my Instagram story. which I'll be filming on Friday and putting the polls up on Friday. So make sure you follow me on my Instagram at Sheree.Chinn, so you guys can control my life and vote on there. And I'll be doing what is voted most on Friday all day. So make sure you follow me on there. And I'll see you guys for a new video. And I love you guys so, so much. And I'll see you guys soon for a new video. Bye! I've been watching over and over again because I love it so much. And it has Joey King in it from who played Ramona on Ramona and Beesus. And it's really, really good. So I recommend you guys to watch it. Because it's a romantic comedy if you're into that kind of stuff. Which I love romantic comedies. They're awesome and I think you guys should watch it. It's really good. And I give it a 10 out of 10. I rate it a 10 out of 10. I just love it so much.